Hi, hello, it's Anne. Welcome back to my channel and welcome to a brand new video. Today I'm gonna be doing something really, really exciting that I've been wanting to do for years. Like years, you guys. I'm gonna be painting my denim jacket. This is just an old denim jacket from H&M that I've had forever, and it's gonna be my canvas today. I'm gonna be focusing on this back part right here. You can see there's a lot of nice even space. It's kind of like a canvas feeling. So this back piece is gonna be my main focus, and then I'm also gonna be painting on the front pockets right here. So what I'm gonna be using for this painting is the Artesa 30 colors of 3D fabric paint, along with the 24 set of non-3D fabric paint, question mark? Just normal fabric paint. These come in bottles of 60 milliliters, and as I said before, they're a set of 24. As for the 3D fabric paint, what's really cool is that it comes with these different tips that you can use to make, it's, you know, it kind of turns into a piping bag, if that makes any sense to any of you. You know, you have like different piping tips, and it's gonna, like when you squeeze the paint out of these tips, it's gonna give you different results depending on what tip you're using. And these bottles come in 29 milliliter, kind of like little, very tall bottles, and you're supposed to get 8 extra tips, but I think accidentally they put 2 of those in mine, so I got another 16, which is great. Something that I thought was really, really fun was the fact that both of these sets actually have a bunch of metallic paints, which is pretty darn fun, along with some glitter paints, and there's even a glow-in-the-dark paint. I'm not gonna be using any of these like specialty paints today, but I thought it was really fun, and it's definitely something that I'm gonna be looking into for future projects. I already have a few projects planned out, and I'm so excited about it. So I have heaps of paint to use. And this right here is the piece that I'm gonna be painting. I first sketched out a kind of rough sketch on my iPad and planned out where I wanted everything. And as I was kind of placing this on the jacket, I felt like the top was very, very like bland, and it was a lot of dead space up there in the sky. So what I did was that I kind of just enlarged some of the elements, like the sun, the clouds, and the bird, and then I just added those in on top. And I probably made this whole process way more complicated than it has to be, but for me, I didn't know how to like cleanly transfer the sketch to the jacket without leaving permanent marks. So I decided to just cut all of the pieces out and trace them with a ballpoint pen, because that's what I found that showed up on the fabric. And I just traced around all of the shapes, and then I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna fill all of this in with just a base coat of white. And once I've done that, I'm gonna be able to sketch with a lighter pencil, just to kind of define more details and stuff like that. But this is kind of where I started out, and I was experimenting between the two different kinds of paint. I had the 3D kind of puffy paint, and then I had the non-puffy normal fabric paint. And I did find that I preferred using the non-puffy paint, mainly probably because I was using it with a paintbrush. I wasn't using the 3D element at all. So what I was doing was I took that 3D paint and I treated it like a normal paint, which probably, you know, isn't bringing out the best qualities in the paint, because I'm not using it the way it's supposed to be used. So that would be an explanation as to why I prefer the other paint, because it's actually meant to be brushed on. The other one's meant to be squeezed on. But yeah, that's that's my conclusion. The fabric paint was definitely in need of a base coat. It was seeping into the fabric pretty intensely, and I ended up doing two layers of this white base coat before I went in with all of the colors and details on top, and I am so glad I did this. The first layer in particular was insanely time consuming. I don't know, you guys, I had so much footage from this video. It's I think I broke all my records. My camera kept overheating, it kept running out of battery, it kept running out of space on the memory card, and it was just, this video was a hassle. I did have a lot of fun, I did. And I'm really happy that I got the opportunity to kind of just play around with these paints a little bit, because now I have so many ideas. I have this pair of sneakers that I actually bought with the intent of painting them or drawing on them when I was working at a shoe shop like years and years ago. And they've just been sitting in a box in my office since then. So I'm definitely gonna be painting those in the future. And if that's something that you wanna see, let me know. And you know, I can film it. Otherwise, I'm just gonna do it on my spare time. So yeah. Anyways, I definitely was not expecting the paint to behave this way. I don't, you know, I thought it was gonna be just like acrylics, but it's somehow like, it's kind of tacky in the texture, if that makes any sense. I don't know. But it was a struggle to blend. I really, really had to get used to it. Oh yeah, here you can see me just trying out how to add in the details, because I was, again, I was experiencing the paint is very tacky, as I was just saying, and I was not ready to make the commitment of actually putting the detailed paintbrush to this jacket and trying to do all of the outlines with a brush and this paint. So what I did was I dug up my Sharpie stained like fabric markers, and I actually ended up doing all of the outlines with this pen. And I am so happy I decided to do this, because it would not have turned out this neatly if I didn't. Here you can see me just starting adding in a bit of the color in the birdies, and I actually end up changing this color because it wasn't quite what I wanted. I spent a lot of time contemplating what color scheme I wanted, and you'll see me a bit later struggling with the green. Holy cannoli, you guys. But I decided to eventually I end up going with a way more muted color palette, which I really enjoy. You can see the blue that I'm putting down right now. It's almost like a very cool gray tone with like just a hint of blue in it. And this is kind of what set the tone and the vibe for the rest of the color palette, which I'm stoked with how this turned out. It all has this like bluish hue to it, which like ties in really, really nicely with the denim. And yeah, I what was I saying before? The paint was tacky. Yes, blending. Holy. Oh my goodness. I was so frustrated for a while when I was trying to blend the wings, because it just wasn't blending. It just wasn't. But after a while, I got the hang of it. I did read on the packaging that you can actually dilute the paint with water, and that helped a lot. At first, I like over diluted it, and it just looked really wonky and weird. So I took some time just to kind of figure out how these blended, and it took a little while, but once I got it, I felt like I got it, you know. And it was definitely a learning curve, but I'm so impressed with the results, and it was well worth it. I had a blast. This has taken like over a week to film, which is why you see me changing shirts and whatnot every now and then, because I could not physically make this happen in like one or two days like I normally do my videos. So yeah, sorry, this video is really, really late, and I've been stressing out all week trying to get this video done. And I wanted it up by Friday originally, and then I was like, okay, I'm just gonna post it sometime over the weekend. But you know, I'm working full-time already, and this is kind of my side hustle. So I've been working like every waking moment trying to get this done. And it's so much layering, and waiting for the paint to dry. Thank God it dries really quickly. And I didn't actually smudge the paint at any point, which is quite impressive. Because normally I would put my hand in wet paint and then I would smear it all over the canvas before I realize what I've done. And I didn't do that this time. So it dries very fast. That's also something to get used to as you're painting, because, you know, if you're gonna blend things, you're gonna wanna blend them right away, because if you wait for like 5 minutes, that ship has sailed, my friend. So the whole inspiration for this piece is actually like kind of like traditional tattoo, like, you know, like flash art. Basically, you got these like really bright and bold kind of symbols and things like that with the thick outline. That feeling, does that... I'm not the greatest at explaining things, but I hope you know what I mean. Otherwise, just Google it. Google it and you'll see what I mean. Yeah, okay. It's a plan. At this point, you can see me mixing a green and heating it. And then after this shot, you can see it just jumps to to a completely different color. And I think I spent like half an hour mixing this color and just trying to get the right shade. Yeah, that was fun. Okay, you guys, I want to take this moment to tell you guys that the fabric paints that I'm using in this video were actually sent to me by Arteza, and they asked me if there's any art supplies that I would like to try out, and I was like, hey, you know, I've been wanting to paint my denim jacket for a while, so how about you shoot me over some fabric paints and I can try them out. And so they did. So I want to be really clear with the fact that these paints are gifts to me. However, I am not sponsored. All opinions are 100% my own, as they always will be. I would never ever be dishonest with you guys and recommend you guys something that I didn't believe in myself. So I just want to be like really, really clear about that, that I'm, you know, I wouldn't do that to you guys. So yeah, I just want to say that. And with that said, all of the links in the description box are affiliate links, so I do receive a small commission out of each purchase if you choose to use those links. I also have a discount code, is ANCAKES9, and it's valid until August 22nd, which funnily is my birthday. Fun times. Okay, anyways, it gives you 10% off your entire purchase if you want to pick up these fabric paints or anything else off of the Arteza website. That's a discount code for you guys. And just know that all of the links that I have in the description box are affiliated. And without further ado, I'm just gonna keep talking about the piece now. So yeah, this piece in particular, I was just going forth and back and I didn't know what I was doing at some point. And I felt quite disconnected from the piece as I was trying to mix that hideous green that I was using in the first place. As I said earlier, I think what I ended up doing is I chose a very muted color palette, and it all has this like blue kind of cool tone to it, which just binds it all together and makes it look quite organic together with the denim, which is a quality that I really, really enjoy. It just looks the way I wanted it to in my head. And lately I haven't been a big fan of my art, I'm not gonna lie. I've been in the phase where, you know, you just see the things that you can improve on. And with that said, there's a lot of improvements to be done. I have a lot of work to do, and I'm definitely gonna be studying some more color theory. I'm gonna be doing more landscape painting and things like that, and just trying to up my skills to be at the level where I want them to be. And so yeah, I think that's all I have to say about this piece for now. Here is the awkwardest footage of me showing off the final product. Yeah, it was an experience. I hope you enjoy. Okay, thank you so much for watching. I hope you're having a lovely day or night or evening or whatever it is as you're watching this, and I will see you guys in my next video. Thank you so much for watching and happy painting. Bye.
I'm great at this.